Welcome to RNA Biology with Eterna. My name is Riju Das. I'm a professor at Stanford University School of Medicine, and I'm the principal investigator of the Eterna project. We're studying RNA because of its fundamental roles in the origin of life, in modern biology, such as in human bodies and in bacteria, and in the many organisms that could provide a solution to climate change, like plants and marine organisms. And we're studying RNA because it may form the basis of novel materials, as well as novel medicines, like mRNA vaccines and CRISPR gene therapies. We're going to learn about the basic biology of RNA. What are the RNA molecules that underlie all of life? We're going to understand how these RNAs fold up into really beautiful, intricate folds through the phenomenon of base pairing. And we'll describe those folds both in terms of two-dimensional cartoons and three-dimensional structures. After that, we'll look at the ribosome. This is a 3D machine in our cells and all living cells that makes proteins, and it's actually made mostly of RNA. We're then going to talk about applications of RNAs in modern biotechnology and synthetic biology. We'll be looking at how actual experimentalists in our labs synthesize RNA and understand how it folds and how it functions. In this course, we're going to use a video game called Eterna. Eterna is a project that started in 2011, and since that time, Eterna has crowdsourced problems that are intractable for expert scientists and our supercomputers to citizen scientists on the internet who play this interactive video game and actually provide RNA sequences that they think might fold up into structures or have functions that we need. And then my lab and our collaborators have been taking these RNA sequences and actually synthesizing them in the wet lab. And we've invented technologies to characterize their structures and functions to find out if these Eterna players are correct. And through that virtuous cycle of gameplay and experimental feedback, Eterna has produced over 30 scientific papers, including insights, RNA design tools, and benchmarks that have become standards throughout RNA science. Through it all, Eterna developers and players have worked hard to refine the game so that new people who have no prior expertise can onboard and become RNA scientists. We hope you have fun. Enjoy learning by solving puzzles. We hope to see you after the course as participants in the Eterna project, where we're always tackling cutting-edge science and RNA engineering. And we hope you become our colleagues as biologists and biotechnologists in the RNA world.
Welcome to Eterna Academy's course on RNA biology. In this video, we'll be exploring the structure and function of RNA molecules, including the bond strengths of different base pairs. RNA molecules are composed of a single strand of ribonucleotides with four different bases: adenine and guanine, which are double-ringed bases called purines, and cytosine and uracil, which are single-ringed bases called pyrimidines. The bases pair up in specific ways. Adenine pairs with uracil, and guanine pairs with cytosine or with uracil. The strength of these base pairs varies depending on the number and type of chemical bonds involved. AU base pairs have two hydrogen bonds, while GC base pairs have three hydrogen bonds, making them stronger and more stable. GU base pairs have two hydrogen bonds, but their geometry results in weaker stacking, interactions, and reduced stability. The strength and stability of these pairs help determine the shape and structure of the molecule. This, in turn, affects the RNA's ability to interact with other ions or molecules, such as metals, amino acids, small molecules, and proteins, and carry out its functions. Keep in mind that RNA is dynamic. It can change its shape, and therefore its function, influenced by its environment and energetic properties. In general, RNA folds into the shape that requires the least energy based on its sequence of nucleotides, often with several intermediate steps. RNA molecules are like tiny machines, which help carry out many different biological functions. Messenger RNA is the most well-known type of RNA, as it carries the genetic code from DNA to the ribosomes where it's used as a template to synthesize proteins. Other types of RNA, such as transfer RNA and ribosomal RNA, also play important roles in this process. During translation, transfer RNA reads the genetic code carried by the messenger RNA and lines up the right amino acids to make the protein, while ribosomal RNA triggers the reaction to join the amino acids together using peptide bonds. In addition to their role in protein synthesis, RNA molecules help regulate gene expression through mechanisms such as post-transcriptional modifications and RNA interference, which can reduce the production of proteins. And that's a brief overview of RNA biology. Now, try to answer the following questions, and in the next lesson, you will have a chance to play introductory puzzles from Eterna that demonstrate these features.
Hi, my name is Ray. I work as a research technician here at Bass Lab, Stanford University, biochemistry department. I specialize in the chemical mapping of RNA structures. This is the general process of internal library prep or sequencing. When we get our synthesized internal library design pool from a vendor, it comes with single-stranded DNA. So we have to put it through this process called emulsion PCR. Essentially, it's the emulsion of the PCR reaction with minimal oil. So the PCR reaction is trapped into these tiny bubbles. So the purpose for that is to, you know, quarantine different designs so they can have their own double-stranded DNA generation. So after emulsion PCR, we get our double-stranded DNA. We gotta use this double-stranded DNA to do an in vitro transcription. Just like how our body makes RNA, this is just done in a test tube. So we're gonna use this double-stranded DNA as a template to generate the RNA. So we get our RNA molecules. We need to refold it using magnesium ions to restore or to show off this interesting structure of the RNAs. So how are we gonna capture this structural information? How are we gonna take a snapshot of this structural information of the RNA? We're gonna use chemical probing. So there are different kinds of chemical reagent we're gonna use. In the case of shape reagent, here the example showing is the 2A3 shape reagent. Just like other shape reagent, you attach to the 2' hydroxyl part of the sugar ring. For the base, that's also not a base pair, which means this locus is more flexible compared to the base pair ones. So after we get this modified RNAs, we're gonna use that as a template for reverse transcription to generate our cDNA. So the cDNA will have a mutation base corresponding to the modified base of the RNAs. So this is the way we're gonna, you know, transform this chemical modification of RNA into a mutated cDNA. So we need to do a page verification of the cDNA. Essentially, what happens here is I'm gonna run through our cDNA sample through this acrylamide gel. Different sizes of molecules, they're running at a different pace through the gel matrix. For example, smaller ones will run faster to the bottom, larger one will get slow stuck in the top. So here we take a look and we're just gonna cut and extract the cDNA in the right size. So this process is trying to make sure that we get the right size of the cDNA and also to get rid of the impurity or off product that's generated through the reverse transcription. So we have our cDNA, we're gonna do the amplification PCR to bring back, first off, the number of the molecules, also make it into double-strand DNA. Again, this double-strand DNA has captured all the RNA structure coming from the chemical modification in a form of mutated base here. So we're gonna use this double-stranded DNA sequencing analysis. After we get the sequencing data back, we'll run our own analysis to generate RNA structural information.